Let's talk all things journaling using these three planners and journals of the year. The first point about journals I would like to explain is journal prompts. So these prompts are around true self, and see the prompts like what activities make you lose time. So that is flow. What makes you feel great about yourself? So that points to your ikigai. So these kind of journal prompts. The second page I would like you to add in your journal is this kind of core values. So you have all the values written together and choose your five core values. Now each year your values may change depending on the kind of life you are having. Okay, so that is the tip number two. Tip three, this kind of scorecard. Both my journals have this kind of scorecard, 0 to 10, and you can use it for the different aspects of your life, like body, mind, relationship, world around me, fun, recreation, environment, spirituality, happiness, and score yourself on 10. Somehow this didn't work for me because I can't objectively give myself a score on something so subjective. Tip number four is making a roadmap for the big goals for the year. So there would be just three big goals for the year. And then you would write a summary of what it means, the motivation, the why behind why you want to achieve it. Three milestones, and this could be fitness goals or whatever. So three milestones which you reach and the support you would need for it, the impact it would have on your life and others, and the reward which you would give yourself after you have achieved the goal. Tip five is this kind of emotions year in pixel page with Jan, Feb, all the months here and all the days here. And you pick a color for every emotion so you know how your year went. I didn't finish this, but this was really interesting. Tip number six is having a mental health page with positive affirmations, trigger words which get you in the put you in a spiral, and my hard to swallow pills which could be some hard truths which you have to face. Tip number seven, especially for influencers, would be having your months and your Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, all your things, and how many followers or how many views you have per month. So it gives you kind of numbers. Tip number eight would be this kind of a grid every month to break down your goals monthly, and you can take a screenshot of this. This really helped. Tip number nine is this kind of review page on what worked, what did not work for the month, how are you feeling, what do you need, and what you can, the celebrations and wins for the month. So this page is a lovely one too. Tip number 10 is having a handy tracker like this, where you just have the habits which you want to track and just tick off the days as you finished them. So that is the whole month, 31 days, different tracking habits. I hope you like the top 10 tips I've shared for journal writing, and these pages you can make for your own, or you can buy any of these planners to plan your year and months.